I want to talk about expectation, because I think expectation is something we don't do a good job with in our clinics. And this is a really neat study that actually addresses expectation and what it may be doing under the hood. So what they did in the study was to take patients at baseline, and they looked at dopamine synthetic capacity as well as serotonergic synthetic capacity. And then they did a deceptive randomization. And this is something that requires a special level of IRB approval. It typically requires an ethics board that's independent, because they deceived patients that were participants in the trial. And there's also an incredibly complicated unblinding process that's part of this. So what they did was they told some patients that they would be getting a placebo, but they were getting an SSRI. And they told other patients that they were going to be getting a very effective SSRI. Now, what happened? Well, as you can see in the third panel, there were no changes between the deceived patients and the ones who were told that they were actually, in fact, getting an SSRI in terms of serotonin. But what changed with that expectation was actually dopamine. What also changed, and what I think is really important for me as a clinician, is that when you tell patients that they're getting something inactive that's not going to work, or that they assume is not going to work, they don't respond as well. Right? I don't think this is a surprise to any of us, but I work with a lot of residents in my clinic, and when I hear them talk with patients about the medications, it's this, well, you know, we can kind of try this, and, you know, if that doesn't work, I mean, we can probably try something else, and, you know, I mean, like, there are studies that show average response, you know, tends to, right? Like, this is probably not how we should be talking about our medicines relative to the amount of evidence that we have, particularly for the SSRIs, because expectation matters.